What is poppin', calisthenics fam? My name is Brennan Myers, and today we're gonna be talking about bench press versus push-ups. Which is better and which should you be doing? All right, so when we talk about bodyweight training, obviously push-ups in this case, and then weight training, the bench press, whether it is flat, incline, decline, whatever it may be, you know, we really have to focus on a few different things before we decide, hey, this is better than this, and I'll get to that in just a few moments. But first of all, what is your goal? Is it to have more relative strength? Because this is very, very important. You might want to be doing more bodyweight training. Or maybe your maximal strength, in this case, would be weight training. How about power? How about muscular endurance? Do you even have access to a gym? Maybe you want to work out in your house, you know, 30 minutes to 40 minutes every single day. Or maybe you do want to spend that $50 per month. Whichever is the case for you, we have to design a program off of your goal. And this is where we could say, hey, bench press is most important for you, or push-ups are most important for you. And then, you know, combining and how exactly we do that. So in this video, I kind of want to just bring you to an educated decision at the end, and you know, you make a decision for yourself. And I know without a doubt, you'll be able to see incredible results with the information that I'm about to give you. So first of all, let's just dive into push-ups and then we'll go into the bench press. So for your push-ups, the biggest question I receive is, can you really build size and strength with just a push-up exercise or bodyweight movements? And the answer is absolutely. It all comes down to one thing, and actually many things, but the most important thing being variation. You can increase variation so many different ways, especially for a push-up, going a little bit wider out with your hands, maybe time under tension a little longer throughout the whole movement, speed of the movement. Also, increased variation in a way where the intensity is a lot harder by maybe you're doing a Superman push-up or something that's a lot more difficult. Leverage is very, very important with bodyweight training. So is there a limit though with the specific movements that you are doing depending on your body weight? Yes or no? I would say if you're 110 pounds, 130, 140 pounds compared to a 200 pound person, obviously it's going to be a little bit more difficult for the 200 pound person, right? Or a lot more difficult because you have more resistance. Although that's only the case for someone who's been training for a while and is used to specific variations. That's why we always increase it and make it harder. So that's a yes and no answer for that. What should you really be focusing on as only doing push-ups or incorporating push-ups into your workouts? Well, first of all, your rep range. Rep range is extremely, extremely important. I always say 6 to 13 repetitions for hypertrophy. And that's what I really want to focus on in this video, because everyone wants to build a lot of size in that chest area. So let's just focus in on that for right now. Your volume is also going to be extremely, extremely important with any type of workouts that you're doing, whether it's in the gym or bodyweight training. This is going to be key. It is key. So for you, I'm going to recommend 4 to 5 different exercises. You can do one more than that, a little bit less than that, all depending on how you understand the structure of your training, the intensity level of that day, and things like that. Also what you're eating, your sleep, and those type of mechanisms. Now your sets, this is really, remember, volume is sets times reps. So your sets are going to be 3 to 5 sets, sometimes even 6 sets, depending again on your level, how long you've been training for. Do you understand biomechanics? Do you understand the variations that you're incorporating and the intensities and all those cool fun facts? And then your repetitions, again, hypertrophy. I will not repeat this ever again. I'm just kidding. I probably will many, many times in other videos, but it's 6 to 13 repetitions. I like to stay more around 6 to 10 repetitions, but 6 to 13 is a general idea for you with bodyweight training. Now your frequency, you should be training 3 times per week. This is going to be, again, key, because we don't only want to just train 2 times per week. If we're really, really focusing on a movement, we want to adapt as quickly as possible and then increase variation, make it harder, increase intensity. So the way we do this is we increase a day. This will increase volume. Remember, volume is extremely important, right? Now, what are you eating? This will also have a huge effect on your overall strength gains, how big your muscles are getting. So if you are in a caloric intake of like higher than whatever your maintenance weight is, so 500 calories, remember, 500 calories more intake calorically will be attributed to, in 1 week, 3,500 calories, which is 1 pound. So if you're doing it right, if you're eating correctly, the micronutrients, the vitamins, minerals, all those really cool, fun things that we always talk about in so many different videos, you will definitely see an increase increase in muscle size, strength, power, and muscular endurance. Now, when we talk about weight training, you know, maybe you want to increase more maximal strength. This is more relative to strength training in the gym, or maybe it is size. You want to really build a lot more size a little bit faster. This is going to be more gym work. Although I will always say, even though we are focusing on our bench press, we do not want to forget about the body weight movements. I incorporate both, and I've seen incredible results with thousands of my transformations of my clients. And just like you, you've watched my videos for a really long time. Maybe you're someone new. You know, my philosophy works when you're not saying, hey, I only want to do bodyweight training. You could do weights as well. The combination is incredible, especially when you're combining the weighted exercises like the bench press with bodyweight plyometric exercises. Remember, transferring that energy really, really fast. So awesome and fun to incorporate. So let's say strength and size is your goal. We want to find, first of all, that one rep max. This is so important. This is really how we measure maximal strength. You can do 3 rep max. So you take a weight and you obviously warm up, maybe a 5 rep max. You warm up and then you find out your overall, just how much you can push throughout one specific movement. From here, we can decide, okay, how do we build size? How do we increase power? How do we increase strength and muscular endurance? It's all based off of percentages, especially when it's coming down to your compound movements. So compound movements are things like your overhead press, you have your bench press, which we're talking about right now, and also your squat, your deadlift. So percentages and rep ranges are going to be key, obviously volume as well. So if you want to build size, now keep this in mind, write it down, whatever you need to be doing. You need to be doing about 70 to 85% of your 1 rep max for 6 to 10 repetitions. This is key to build the hypertrophy of your muscles, 70 to 85%. Now, if you're more strength oriented, you really wanna build strength, maybe you're not so focused on really gaining a lot of size, you wanna build that maximal strength, 77 to 95% of your 1 rep max. Remember, you're gonna test your 1 rep max, then get these percentages. From that, there's so many tables you could type in on Google and find. And here you're gonna be doing 2 to 5 reps to build more strength. Keep that in mind. Now, volume. What should you be doing for volume for bench press if you do have a gym, if you do have the money for a gym? Again, it's not necessary, not at all. You could build incredible size, muscle, and strength with bodyweight training. Now, with volume for weight training, you should be doing 3 to 5 sets, but you could also go as high as 10 sets. I would not recommend it unless you understand the structure of linear periodization, undulating periodization. Again, that's way more in depth. Then linear periodization is actually not as in depth as undulating, but we're not even gonna get into that. Just stick around 3 to 5 sets. Now, your frequency, I always recommend 3 times per week. Again, maybe a high intensity day, then we got a low intensity day for Wednesday, and then we have a high or moderate intensity day for Friday. So you're always hitting all those phases, and you're really increasing that volume, and you're also just staying active within that same specific movement. If you're used to a movement, remember, you're always getting used to it. You're building strength. You're building those intrinsic muscles to make sure they're used to this specific exercise, which will again translate to bigger strength gains, hypertrophy, and muscular endurance. Okay, so remember, there's so many different goals, different types of strength. You can build size with weight training. You can also build size with body weight training. I do not want you to say, oh, well, Brendan said that I can only do weight training because I want to build incredible size. No, if you're dieting correctly, you're eating correctly, this is what is key actually in the end. Obviously, you need to be training right, but if you're not eating right, you won't see results. It's just that you might see a little bit of results, but not optimally. You're not optimally creating this system for yourself that will lead you to the results that you want. So if you don't have the money, do body weight training. If you are in the weight training realm and you want to just increase your flat bench, you think it's the best way ever, make sure you're still incorporating those body weight push-ups, variations, the Supermans, any type of plyometric movement with that chest, and you will see incredible strength, hypertrophy, power, and muscular endurance gains, I promise you. I have been doing this for many, many years now. I've seen it. My philosophy is key with all my programs. The way I structure it, it works in the gym or only bodyweight training. So stay up, keep on grinding, keep on working towards whatever you believe is best for your situation. I do suggest you make a decision, but also switch it up all the time. Don't always do a gym workout. Have fun with bodyweight training as well. Or if you do have access to a gym, go ahead and do so. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Wanted to just bring this different setting. We got the calisthenics blue behind us. Not really, but kind of. I got the little chair. You know, I'm sitting down. I'm feeling all perky. It's a weird word. Josh, is that a weird word? Anyways, thanks for tuning in. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Make sure you hashtag calisthenics. Subscribe if you haven't already. That's very important, because if you don't subscribe, you don't see the next video about chest and you don't build the chest that you really want. No, I'm just kidding. You will build the chest that you want. Just take this information and keep on moving forward. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time. Peace. I just dabbed.